Hi guys, and welcome to my review of Haikyuu chapter 208, First Snow. And this chapter was quite interesting. We got a lot of revelations and a lot of setup, and let's get into it. So we start off with Kageyama being invited to the all-youth training camp, which was introduced also last chapter with the invitation at the end. And we see that he accepts, of course, and there are a lot of funny moments between this point and then the next I'm gonna talk about in a little bit. But basically they talk a lot about what the all-youth Japan thing really is and how amazing it is that Kageyama has been invited to this. They also touch upon the subject of Nishinoya not being invited because it is common knowledge that the two geniuses that they have is Kageyama and Nishinoya. And they think about how this may be and why, and they kind of end up at the, like, the conclusion that Nishinoya is just not mature enough to be part of such an elite training camp because he wouldn't do well with the other people or whatever. I think that's a bit of a bullshit excuse because Nishinoya is as good as he is, and they said that, of course, all these people, they're coming together and they don't know each other, so they need to be able to work together, and Nishinoya is so good at working with people, so it would be kind of weird not to invite him, I think. So I think that's kind of a bullshit reason, but whatever. I think there might be something else to it, or maybe he's gonna be invited at some other point or whatever. I don't know. I don't know how it works, but I think he should have been invited, basically. The second revelation is the one that I'm most excited about, is that Tsukishima is being invited to another training camp, and that is the Miyagi training camp for good first years or whatever the fuck. I don't think they had an actual name for this in the chapter, but basically it was just that the first years that the people of Miyagi, whoever they are, they saw potential in their being invited to this elite training camp that is supposed to heighten the level of volleyball players in the Miyagi prefecture. And that's what Tsukishima's being invited to because, of course, as we saw in the Shira Torizawa match, Tsukishima was really good and he's gotten so good over the last, what, half a year or whatever? Like, props to Tsukishima. And I think this may further his character development. I actually thought that we were kind of done with this because there's been so much focus on him lately. But I think that he's just such a popular character and that the person who's writing this, I don't remember his name, just sees more potential for Tsukishima, like we all do, but I think that this series is gonna continue on for quite some time, and it's gonna continue until Hinata's a first year, or a third year, so I'm kinda surprised that Tsukishima is getting this much exposition and this much development so early on. But there are also some really funny moments when Tsukishima is invited, because first he tries to decline the offer, and then Daichi is just like, nah, he'll participate, why shouldn't he? And then there's a lot of like references to Tsukishima's other, what should we call them, volleyball companions who he trained with, that aren't Karasuno, so his brother's team, Bokuto and Kuro, who of course has taught him a lot. Then we get a short training montage where we just like kind of see the days pass by, and there they have some practice matches, and we see Hinata practicing his receives and stuff like that. Stuff we've seen before, just like to show that time is passing. And then we see this really beautiful shot of the first snow coming and Hinata biking on like a mountain or something, and at first I thought that he was gonna get injured or something, like the snowstorm or the snow seemed like it was gonna be a storm and he was gonna hit something or whatever. I thought he was gonna be injured, but that's not it. What really happens is that Hinata has snuck in, I don't think you can call it be snuck in, but you know what I mean. He snuck into the training camp that Tsukishima is supposed to participate in. And we all know that, I mean, at this point, he can't be rejected. Like, they're not just gonna throw him out, he's the main character, they can't do that, he's got main character protection. So it's gonna be fun to see how that plays out. Also, on another note, when Kageyama was going to the training camp, his training camp, he kind of got lost because he couldn't read the kanji or something. And I'm kind of wondering, is that supposed to either be a gag, or is that gonna be something important? Like, is he gonna get lost and then meet someone? Like, that would be super interesting if he got lost and something happened. Lastly, I wanna mention Yamaguchi, because now he's again the first year who's not doing anything. Like, we have Kageyama in the all-new training camp, and we have Tsukishima and Hinata kind of illegally participating in the Miyagi training camp. What about Yamaguchi? Something has to happen to him because he has this really steady character development and just like general development in his volleyball skills. And I don't think that he would just sit by and do nothing. Like, he kind of joked about just sitting, just housewarming or whatever the fuck he says, house sitting? I don't know. But I don't think that's gonna happen. As Tsuki said, house sitting for him just means more training, because Yamaguchi wants to be on their level, and Yamaguchi's gonna get there eventually. I'm a big fan of the theory that when they reach their third year, Yamaguchi's gonna be the captain, because I don't really see any of the other first years taking that role. I mean, Tsukishima is too awkward for it, Kageyama is too kingly, and I don't think that would work, and Hinata, no way, he's gonna be the ace, he's not gonna be the captain. But yeah, that was my review. If you like anything I had to say, please give it a thumbs up. And leave in the comments below what you thought of this chapter and what you think the story is going. And subscribe if you want to see more of me. I do Haikyuu and One Piece reviews so far. I may start doing some other things when I've gotten into the groove of doing these reviews. And yeah, bye!